So, welcome to the team building of week 8 in the UGA. We, the Charging Charizards, face the Fusion Fishes and coach Nougat Boy. Currently we are number 1 seed after our win versus Silent last week, and he lost this week as well, so we can secure our number 1 spot going into playoffs if we win this match. So let's see if we can do it. Fusion Fishes currently is 11th spot, 2-5 in record, I think. So he does not have a chance to get playoffs, but still I definitely respect him and his team, and I could see this becoming quite a battle if he maybe surprises me with some unique mods or unique sets. So let's see. In terms of must bring this week, I have Primarina, Neuvern, Neostic and Manectric. Primarina mainly because most of his team is very special and also really threatening towards Charizard and other members of my team, especially the Inteleon and the Pelipper mode, and also for some extent Hawlucha and Mamoswine, and Primarina just beats all of them. He pretty much only has Galvantula and Exeggutor for Primarina, and all other members of his team cannot really touch Primarina. So Primarina for me is an absolute no-brainer. Inteleon just does nothing to it. Really, absolutely nothing. So yeah, Primarina really good this week. Neuvern, once again, needed for Tailwind speed control. Not as effective this week, maybe because he has also Tailwind, even priority Tailwind, but still Neuvern outspeeds everything on his team, so I think I really need Neuvern. And also he does not have a single flying resistance, so that's also really really good for Neuvern. Meowstic, he has weather. I feel like I'm forced to bring Meowstic to maybe change the weather if necessary, and also Meowstic provides fake out, so for example I could fake out Whimsicott. That would be very valuable. Then we have Manectric. Manectric basically to help Primarina doing its job. As I said, Galvantula is one of the few mons that can really touch Primarina, and he brought Galvantula a couple of times, so I really expect him to bring it. And Manectric is just really good versus it, since it does not care about any electric type move Galvantula wants to go for. So yeah, Manectric really good. Matchups like this is the reason why I drafted Manectric in the first place, so I have to bring it. Considering mons, we have Charizard. Despite him having Inteleon and Pelipper and Galvantula, I still could see Charizard doing work, especially with Meowstic support, and as I said, he doesn't have a single flying resistance, so Maxair streams are really powerful versus him. Drakki may does not seem really good because he has like Galvantula, he has Pelipper, he has Incineroar, he has Hawlucha, but at the same time Drakki is really good versus Inteleon. It can just revenge KO it after Dynamax. It's really good versus Mamoswine, and it has another fake out component to my team, and yeah, that alone could be really valuable. I know that I might power up his grass moves as well, but I mean, that should be fine, I think. And the last one I considered bringing was, or is, Urshifu. Urshifu just hits once again a lot of his team. He is another member of the league that does only have one fairy type, and yeah, Whimsicott is good, but I have a lot of checks versus it with Charizard and Ivan specifically. So I could see Urshifu doing some work here, especially since it outspeeds not everything, like 4 mons outspeed it, but still it provides really good damage versus Mamoswine, versus Incineroar, versus Exeggutor, and priority sucker punch could be really valuable. So I considered Urshifu. In terms of Never Brinks, Blissey, unfortunately he has two really good fighting types, so Blissey may not be as effective, and I also expect him to bring Taunt Whimsicott, and this shuts down Blissey way too much. Trevenant, if I wanted to go for Trick Room, I could see myself bringing it, but once again, he has Taunt, he has multiple Max Airstream options, he has Incineroar, he has Mamoswine, it just, I don't see it doing too much. Hilloswine is a rain team with some grass types and even Incineroar, so, and fighting types, so that's really not the game for Pillowswine. And Excadrill, pretty much the same thing. Inteleon beats it way too hard. Incineroar limits its offensive pressure on the field. Hawlucha outspeeds it. Mamoswine with Sash can be annoying. It just does not do enough this week. Yeah, in terms of what I expect him to bring, as you can see, I expect him to bring Garantula, Inteleon, Pelipper and Whimsicott, so pretty much his most offensive mode possible. Garantula must bring for him because Charizard and Primarina are way too threatening for him. Same for Inteleon, really good versus Charizard. Pelipper for the rain, I do expect, although I may see him not bringing Pelipper, since Pelipper also powers up Primarina and I like to bring Sunny Day, but in the end I still think Pelipper, I mean, he liked to bring it a lot, so I would expect him to bring Pelipper. Whimsicott, absolute must bring. He needs to match the Tailwind, he needs the fairy coverage, I think, he needs potential taunt, and also, yeah. Luckily, he does not get rain dance, Whimsicott only gets Sunny Days, so he cannot do some shenanigans versus me. In terms of likely, I could see Exeggutor coming. Exeggutor really threatening versus Primarina, but that's pretty much it. But it's also really good in case I set up Sun, because it could run Chlorophyll, and then outspeed, I would think, every one of my team. So yeah, I would definitely could see Exeggutor coming. Hawlucha, despite being very weak to Charizard, Neuven and Primarina, although it's not as weak to Charizard since it can run rock coverage and not speed it, I could still see it coming because it's just one of his better physical attackers and I think he needs some physical power versus Primarina. Incineroar, I could see it coming. Intimidate could be really valuable, also parting shots, snarls, fake out to stop my Tailwind, to stop some other shenanigans I like to go for. So yeah, Incineroar overall a really good mon and I could see it coming. Last mon I do expect him to bring is Mamoswine. Mamoswine just really good, hits Neuven for super effective damage even with Ice Shard, can run Choice Scarf towards Charizard, can hit Manectric, could hit Trevenant and Excadrill, so yeah, Mamoswine really good mon. Grabblock, really unlikely since Hawlucha is just a better fighting one. Drygon, you don't really want to bring Drygon versus Neuven Primarina. And Porygon, I mean, I could potentially see it maybe if you really really want to go for Trick Room, but if he does not bring Drygon and Grabblock, his Trick Room mode really is non-existent, so I don't see Porygon coming. And even then, I can run Taunt, I can run Fake Out, I have Urshifu, so I just don't see him bringing it, to be honest. Okay, that's the matchup. Now let's see what team I ended up bringing. First of all, like nearly always, we start with Primarina. I just have to drink something real quick. So, this week, once again, Assault Vest. Assault Vest is really good because the majority of the team is special hitting, so yeah, not really much reason to not bring a sword by Spamarina. Stupidly, I ended up bringing Liquid Voice. I think I had Hyper Voice at some point and then just forgot to change the ability. The team is already gent from my friend, so yeah, now I have to run Liquid Voice, but it is what it is. I don't expect this to matter really much, since I'm not seeing myself clicking water moves as much anyway. Okay, in terms of moves, I run Scald this week, not Hydro Cannon, because I really only need the water type attack for Incineroar and maybe Mamoswine, and I may not Dynamax Primarina, so I rather have the safer move, and since I do not need extra power from Hydro Cannon, I rather run Scald. I run Moonblast for the fighting types and Dradigon. Energy Ball is obviously for the Inteleon, and also can hit Mamoswine for super effective damage. And Ice Beam is just for the nasty quest types in Whimsicott and Executor. So yeah, overall really good coverage. In terms of speed, I run enough speed to outspeed Inteleon when I'm in Tailwind. I once again have the 108 special attack to get the extra point, and then just the rest into bulk, since yeah, not much reason to go faster, not much reason to go more powerful, and then just go full in HP and summon special defense, since I don't see myself needing too much physical defensive. I survive pretty much everything I need to with this amount, so yeah, just go more special defensive to really shut down the team. Inteleon just with Life Orb, Max Airstream does like 17% to Dynamax Primarina. Galvantula with Thunder does like 34% or something like that. So yeah, really, really, really bulky, and Primarina should be really hard for him to get rid of. Yeah, Neuvern, Focus Sash this week. I did some kayaks with Yachi Berry, but Inteleon and Mamoswine just did way too much damage to make Yachi Berry worth outside of Dynamax, so yeah, I'd rather go with Focus Sash to survive a hit guaranteed. I will go down to potential hail damage after that, but that should be fine. Frisk, like every week, no reason to not run Frisk. And then I want Taunt, Tailwind obviously, Taunt to potential shutdown Trick Room and his Tailwind options. And then I have Sunny Day, first time I bring Neuvern with Sunny Day. Sunny Day just to really shut down the rain mode and potentially powering up Charizard. And Air Slash, as I said, he has no flying resistance, so I don't need any coverage besides Air Slash. Speed wise, enough speed to outspeed Inteleon, and then the rest into special attack and some bulk. Meowstic, this week with Mental Hub, because Taunt Whimsicott is an option, and I don't want him to taunt me. At least I want to shut down Taunt for one turn if possible. Then I have Fake Out to fake Whimsicott out and maybe just KO it with an Air Slash in case he has no Cobra Berry or Protect. I also can shut down potential Taunt onto Neuvern this way, so yeah, really valuable. Sunny Day, obviously, same reason as I run Neuvern Sunny Day. And Thunder Wave for more speed control, because speed is the name of the game. This week he has Tailwind as well, and as much speed control as I can get, I do want to go for. I also could have went for Scary Face, I think, but Thunder Wave is just, it's permanent, and I really value Thunder Wave for that reason. And then Psychic, because Psychic overall does the most damage to this team. In terms of EVs, I want enough speed to outspeed Italian when I'm plus one. So yeah, that's normally not something I would feel forced to go for, but it's only 20 EVs needed, so not much reason to not go for that. And then I run nearly completely special defense, because this lets me live max moves from Italian and also max buck from Galvantula, so that's really valuable for me. Electric, really interesting set this week. Choice Scarf. The idea behind this is to cover potential Choice Scarf Mamoswine and also to outspeed the few mons that Manectric cannot outspeed otherwise in terms of Galvantula, Holucha and Antillion, and I really could see him get surprised by that. Volt Switch, because Volt Switch can KO Antillion if it is non-bulk. Flamethrower, because Flamethrower is really good versus Galvantula and Mamoswine. And then I run Scary Face. As I said, I want as much speed control as possible, and EV Impulse to shut down his special attackers even more. In terms of EVs, I run enough speed to be faster than Jolly Mamoswine, so even Jolly Scarf cannot outspeed me. And then at first I had bulk. I had enough bulk to live to live an Earthquake from Mamoswine, but in the end I was like, okay, getting the potential 100 KO onto Antillion is way more valuable to me, and since I outspeed Mamoswine anyway, I don't think it will be too likely that I'm forced to take an Earthquake from it. So yeah, that's my Electric for this week, really hoping it can do some work. Charizard this week with a Life Orb, since I need Life Orb to potentially 100 KO Porygon if he runs max HP, max special defense, if you like. Then I need Sunny Day, Solar Power and Life Orb to KO it with a max Wildfire. So yeah, that's pretty much the only reason why I want Life Orb this week, but I really want to cover for that. So yeah, Solar Power because I run Sun. And then Protect Overheat this week, since I'm not forced to run Blast Burn. Overheat gets the KOs it needs. Unfortunately, Heatwave was just a little bit too weak as a max move to guarantee the KO on the Porygon. So yeah, Overheat is just a middle ground play, and yeah, I really like it. Solar Beam for the Mamoswine and the Alien. You may say Overheat is better, but in some situations Solar Beam could be better onto Mamoswine in case he has the affected ability. Air Slash, as I said, he has no flying resistance. In terms of speed, I run enough speed to outspeed Mamoswine. I'm not really sure why I'm 1 point faster than my next trick. Let me see. No, I'm not really sure why am I 1 point faster. Mamoswine, I'm really sure that it hits 145. Yeah, so why am I 147 onto Charizard? I don't remember. But shouldn't matter in the end. Yeah, and I run enough special attack to KO the Porygon, and then I have enough bulk to live an Stone Edge from Mamoswine in case he has Choice Scarf. I also take two Rock Slides from it, when I'm in Dynamax, of course. So yeah, that's really every bulk I need. And once again, 159 HP to take one less damage from Life Orb and one less damage from Solar Power. Yeah, and last member I bring this week is Thraki. I bring Eviolet this week. I thought about Choice Band because Choice Band, Grassy Glide has a really good chance to KO Dynamax and Talion, but in the end I was like, okay, I rather have the bulk, because I feel like I have enough offensive power. I rather have a mon that can switch in and do some utility and may come in the end game and chip down opponents. So yeah, that's tricky for you. I run Protect, Fake Out, Grassy Glide and U-turn. Protect because he has a lot of mons that can hit Thraki, and if I can surprise him by bringing Protect and stall out some terms, I'm really liking to do that. Fake Out, because Fake Out pressure is always really valuable if you can go for it. Grassy Glide, obviously, really good versus Inteleon, has also a 75% chance to KO it, outside of Dynamax of course, and yeah, U-turn just to maintain board control. I really don't need any speed this week. I thought about running 113 speed to make sure that I'm faster than even Adamant Incineroar, but no person runs max speed Incineroar, that just makes pretty much no sense. So I was like, okay, I can just go full bug. And in the end, I think that was the right decision. I won enough HP to get one more, or to get the maximum recovery from Grassy Surge, since it provides 1/16th heal press per turn. So I get 11 HP back at the end of the turn. I run enough defense to lift Max Airstream from Hawlucha, and enough special defense was left so that I lift Expert Belt Max Airstream from Inteleon like 83% of the time, so that's pretty valuable. Yeah, I really kiked a lot with this Thraki, and I think this is close to be the best spread I can bring this week. So yeah, once again I show the team. Surplus Primarina, Sash Neuvern, Mantlop Meowstic, Joyce Guff Manectric, Life of Charizard, and Eviolite Thraki. So yeah, I'm really liking Thraki so far. I brought it last week since I drafted it, and it really surprised me. Although it did not anything, if I remember correctly, but the potential it has while kiking was really good, and this week running a rather bulky set, really nice. It really is a good cheap option if you cannot go for Rillaboom. So I'm really glad that I could grab it this late in the league after it got swapped out. So yeah, thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments what you think about the team, and yeah, I will battle Nougat Boy at 21 CET this day. Currently we are 10 CET, so yeah, video will be up by tomorrow I guess. So yeah, thanks for watching, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you like the content, and yeah, have a good day, see you later, bye.